The lofty expectations of the storied Maryland men's soccer program never waver. Yet the unique circumstances of the 2013 campaign provided extra motivation for the Terps. With the news of its impending move to the Big Ten Conference in 2014, this season will be the final chapter in a long, rich tradition of Maryland soccer in the Atlantic Coast Conference. Once again, Sarofsky assembled one of the most difficult schedules in the nation. The road to the College Cup would be challenging from the start, with a daunting opening weekend on the West Coast against Stanford and California.
I knew it was going to be a real tough challenge going out and playing a Cal team that was unranked, but really we knew they were a great side, and the Stanford team that was rebuilding, and also they were a very good side.
Though it wasn't the result the program was accustomed to, the Terps learned a great deal from the humbling two-game road trip.
I think there was a recognition by the players of what it's really going to take to be successful. And no matter what we did the year before, we've got to go out and prove it. And paying attention to details and making plays and really connecting with each other was going to be important. And I think it set us off in the right path.
Fortunately for Maryland, the friendly confines of Ludwig Field awaited the Terps for the home opener upon their return from California. The stage was set for a Friday night battle against who other than the University of Maryland's most despised foe, Duke. A record crowd of 8,397 fans packed Ludwig for one last ACC showdown with the Blue Devils. The home crowd was bolstered by a hungry crew, which celebrated its 10th anniversary in 2013.
I remember walking out to the warm-up, and there's already like 7,000 people there. I'm like, oh wow. I've never been in this kind of crowd before. I've only been like maybe like 50 to 100 people. So I'm like, wow, this is gonna be big.
People were climbing over the fences and everybody wanted to see the game, and you know, it felt something special. We were a must-see event that night. The crew and all of the rest of Maryland are some of the best fans in the country at any level. Let's
go! Even before the kickoff was so magical that you really felt like you already won. But then the game was special as well. That game with Helga getting winning goals, Subasa getting a nice goal, and Patrick scoring, and it was just a magical night.
Helga had a great goal in that game, and I know that's one of his bigger moments in his career, and one that I'll cherish for sure. It was a big goal for us. We needed it and kind of spurred us on into victory.
It back, Metzger, and Schumer with the shot, and Schumer with the goal, and the Terps on top, 1-0.
The road wouldn't get any easier for the Terps as they faced one of the most challenging ACC slates in recent history. Maryland showed its resiliency away from College Park, recording key results at number 2 North Carolina, number 13 Clemson, number 2 Notre Dame, and number 23 Virginia. During this stretch, the development of the freshman class began to shine.
We knew we had a really special freshman class when we recruited them. We weren't quite sure that they would all be asked to have the kind of impact that they did, but that's the way it is at Maryland. If you're good enough, you're going to play. And if you bring value to the team, you're going to get your opportunity.
I think it showed up with the great performances we had from Sauers, from Suli, to Chris in the back and all over the freshman class. I think it just showed that they were comfortable within the team and were able to develop throughout the season.
For the freshmen, I think we looked at it more as not being nervous, but more of like taking this opportunity, like, hey, this is our opportunity, we're gonna make the most of it. Sasha put so much into learning the Maryland ways, like the Pentagon. We take pride in that, and we touch that every time we leave this locker room. And if we have that in our minds, like, no one can stop us.
I like to think of it as a promise that every time you step into the locker room and every time you leave, you'll remember what this program stands for and how you're supposed to act on and off field, and that's excellence in everything that you do. And that's what the Performance Pentagon means to me, and it's something that will stick with me for the rest of my life.
Timely contributions at both ends of the field were critical to the Terps building up victories and momentum. Sporting an impressive 7-1-3 conference record, Maryland once again captured the ACC regular season crown.
Yeah. Let's go. Right. Okay. Now, can I kick it? Thank you. Yeah, I'm so grateful. I grew up really wanting gold fronts, but that's what you get when Wu-Tang raised you. Y'all can't stop me. Go hard like I got an 808 in my heartbeat. And I'm eating at the beat like it gave a little speed to a great white shark on shark. We raw. Time to go up, gone. Deuces, goodbye. I got a world to see. And my girl, she wanna see Rome. Caesar make you a believer. Nah, I never ever did it for a throne. That validation comes from giving it back to the people. Now, sing this song and it goes like, raise those hands, this is our party. We came here to live life like nobody was watching. I got my city right behind me. If I fall, they got me. Learn from that failure, gain humility, and then we keep marching.
Can we go back? This is the moment.
Went through a tough schedule and we took some knocks and bruises, but I think in the end we showed our true colors and were able to make sure we ended off on the right foot. And obviously it's great leaving the ACC with the championship.
This was one of the strongest years in ACC soccer history. So for us to be able to find a way to keep getting better and win the regular season was really, really special. I mean, I you couldn't write a better script.
Maryland would seek to defend its 2012 ACC tournament title back in Germantown, where hordes of Terrapin faithful once again packed the soccerplex. The Terps faced a familiar foe in the semifinal match with a tough test against Clemson Friday night. After nearly 100 minutes of physical play on a rain-drenched field, freshman midfielder Michael Sauers found the back of the net to spark the Terps back to the title game.
It's something I've never felt before, especially with a crowd. To score that goal and see my teammates run to me, it's the best feeling in the world.
Last year it was Patrick Mullins scoring a goal in a similar spot. This year, Mike Sauers scoring a goal to win the game and really, you know, throw Germantown into a mayhem and set up a great clash with our biggest rival in Virginia.
The Terps had little time to recover for a championship showdown against its biggest rival, Virginia, 2 days later. The stage was set for an epic ACC finale for Maryland. Following a grueling 87 minutes of back and forth action, Mullins was determined to make sure the Terps left the ACC in style as he served the ball into the box, which was deflected into the goal by a Cavalier defender.
It came down to the last couple minutes and I was down on the in line very close to the goal and kind of a tough angle to shoot. Sometimes when you're in those situations, you put it in good places, it ends up in the goal, and that's all I wanted to do, and it worked out well, and I think we deserved the winner at that point.
The own goal gave the Terps the ACC tournament title. It was the first time in program history that the Terps won back-to-back regular season and tournament championships.
I was just really, really happy for the guys, happy for everybody, you know, the newcomers who came to Maryland for those moments, to the seniors who had stuck together. It was a special group through their entire career and had some magical moments, and for all the players in between. But also is happy for our fans, the crew, and just to win and celebrate in that moment, share it with them and the families. It was just really a special moment.
The following week, the Terps were awarded the number 5 overall seed in the NCAA tournament, meaning that Maryland would likely have to travel back to where they started the season, the University of California, for a shot at returning to the College Cup. The Terps took full advantage of their first 2 tournament home matches.
Sauers coming in, into the box. Sauers cuts it back, into the box, flicks it, and it's a goal, Michael Sauers!
In their opening tournament game, Maryland defeated Providence 3-1 to advance to their 12th consecutive Sweet 16, the longest streak in the nation.
Oh, what a feel,
Maryland then dispensed of UC Irvine to punch its ticket back to the West Coast, where a talented Golden Bear team was awaiting the Terps one more time.
Ubasa Endo, good skills toward the edge of the penalty area. Endo crossed it back, and it's a goal, the Terps score! It's Patrick Mullins!
There's that moment of brilliance right there.
Incredible.
Ubasa Endo.
Ding it up, has it on his left, cut, then a shoot! Tipped over the bar! A blast that was going toward the upper 90, and an excellent save from Zack Steffen. Coming into the box, crosses it in, headed, save! The rebound is there, Steffen gets it, and somehow Zack Steffen kept it out.
Facing a California team which had never lost an NCAA tournament game at home would present Maryland with its greatest emotional and physical test of the 2013 season.
I felt like we were really challenged to grow up, and we did, and now have a chance to prove how far we've come, was a really unique opportunity and a great challenge.
When you lose to a team, you say, you know, you want to play them again, you want another shot of them. And when you say that as early as September, you're not sure if it's going to happen. And sure enough, it happened. We're back where we were. And it was, you know, I think it worked out perfectly for us.
With a berth in the College Cup on the line, the Terps rose to the occasion, weathering a staunch Golden Bear attack. Sauers continued his postseason brilliance with a game-winning goal in the final minutes, securing the 2-1 victory and fulfilling the Terps' promise to get back to the College Cup.
I mean, he passed me the ball and I did what I had to do, like anybody on our team would. Once I got the ball, I knew I was going to shoot. I mean, the defenders were backed off. You always have that thought in your head, like, should I pass before you shoot? But it was just get the ball and shoot, and it came out the way I wanted to.
Although the two programs were headed to the city of brotherly love, there was little love lost for rivals Virginia and Maryland as they prepared to square off for a third time, this time at PPL Park in Philadelphia. The stage doesn't get any bigger than the College Cup, and senior Patrick Mullins proved exactly why he will be playing at an MLS stadium in the very near future.
Over the top, Mullins is there. He's behind Virginia. Mullins strikes. It's 1-0 Maryland. Patrick Mullins.
Tisha, this is precise precision. I mean, this is just a thing of beauty.
The back-to-back Hermann Trophy winner scored 2 huge goals to secure the 2-1 victory over the Cavaliers.
Look at that ball to Mullins to make it 2 and seal it. A second goal for Maryland Another piece de resistance.
How about that ball over the top from Endo? Great finish from Mullins. Maryland up 2-0.
The game was rich with highlight reel plays, as both Mullins and freshman goalkeeper Zack Steffen were featured on SportsCenter's top 10 plays the next morning.
Back to Virginia, Maryland. Maryland up 2-1 under 3 minutes to go. Virginia, because Brian James's shot from the top of the box saved by Maryland keeper Zack Steffen to keep Maryland ahead.
Mullins has had two goals, but how good of a save is this?
Although the Terps fell just short of completing their title quest, the 2013 season will go down in history as one of the finest in Maryland soccer annals for many reasons.
Excellent.
The program finished its business in the ACC, once again sent a slew of talented players to the professional ranks, and landed among the stars at yet another College Cup.
We really have great chemistry on this team, and this was a really connected team. I've said a few times that I call this year's team, you know, a resilient team, but also the fun bunch. They were just a joy to be around.
We're like one big happy family. We all stick together. These guys are like my best friends. Maryland will always have a special place in my heart, from this place in the locker room to Testudo on the mall. It's just, it's a great place, and I'll always cherish it.
Distinguished senior class included Jordan Cyrus, Sonny Jane, Helge Leichvang, Patrick Mullins, Gordon Murray, Jake Pace, and Widner St. Cyr. All of these players had a significant role in continuing the legacy of the nation's premier college soccer program.
We've created a culture and a standard of excellence that will not be compromised. No matter who is wearing the jersey, there's always going to be a great amount of pride and effort and quality in the jersey. And we're going to continue to grow our fan base, continue to grow Maryland soccer. Into my third decade here, and the first decade was real good, second decade was better, and now the third decade, we want it to be the best ever.